Now let us see how DB2 uses the coupling facility to share the data. Once again, refer to the diagram which is there on the top of your screen, and it should basically tell you about the coupling facility that is being used to share the data. An integral part of the data sharing environment is the coupling facility. The main function of the coupling facility is to maintain the integrity of the data that's shared by the members of a data sharing group. To do that, it implements the structures as it is shown on the screen to ensure that two DB2 subsystems don't update the same data at the same time. The coupling facilities includes the lock structure. Look at the first rectangle on the triangle given in the center of your screen, which is talking about the lock structure. The lock structure actually provides for the shared and exclusive locking capabilities like those that are provided by DB2. Now, if you understand DB2 locking, then you won't have any trouble understanding the function of the lock structure. The coupling facility also provides a list structure, also called the Shared Communication Area or the SCA. As its name implies, you know, the list structure contains information that's stored in the list. That information can then be accessed by any number of members of the data sharing group. Actually, when an application reads the data, the data is stored in the buffer pool of the DB2 subsystems that requests it. If the data is subject to sharing, it is also registered with the coupling facility. Now, if the data is updated, it is written to a group buffer pool that's a part of the coupling facility cache structure. When that happens, any other member of the data sharing group that has accessed the same data is notified that the data has changed and the copy of the data in that member buffer's pool is invalidated. That member can then retrieve the current data from the group buffer pool. If you note carefully, the cache structure provides a buffer invalidation, a mechanism that tracks the data accessed by the member of the data sharing group and notifies those members when the data changes. The changed data is also stored in the group buffer pools, so it's available to all the members of the group. So that way, the data is shared across two regions. We have a uniformity, and at the same time, concurrency could be maintained. You must also note that the SCA or the list structure is used to store the data such as work queues, directories, and status information that's organized in the list. The lock structure provides the shared and exclusive locking capabilities that prevent more than one application from changing the same data at the same time. So this is how the coupling facility is being used by DB2 to share the data across two different systems. So I hope that basically understanding of DB2 and the architecture of parallel sysplex is clear to all of you, and I hope that it was informative on the different architectures of microservices that are being currently used on the operating system with the DB2. I'm done with my presentation.